Praise the Lord, you are tuning into the media ministry of Apostle Barbara R. Thomas. This ministry is designed to bring forth revelation and encouragement and to enlighten your minds. Now listen as the woman of God brings you revelation from the Word of God.
I heard the Lord say, where are the mocking sounds?
For an invitation, you don't watch. Because there
is a move of God that has been ordained for this hour. He said, you gotta watch, because the enemy is stirred up against what I have called the man and woman of God to do for this time. He began to let me hear the sound of jealousy. He said the preachers are jealous because they wanted it to be them. But I didn't call them. I didn't choose them for this. Because this one is not about money. This one is not about personality. This one is personal. Look at somebody and tell them this one is personal. This is about my destiny. This is about my seed. This is about generations. He said, this is the reason why in this hour he's cutting out the celebrity preachers. And he's looking for those who are humble enough to give him the glory. Oh God. Yeah, come on, shout that along. I said, God, I gotta go do what you got for me to do. And I might not never get invited back again, but I got to obey God, because hallelujah. Look at somebody and tell them it's time for unity. I don't really mess up, because we need to understand, and the word God gave me, because he was showing me, he began to show me water on today. And so I saw this big boulder hit the water, and the water gave a effect. I said, why not a stone? And he said, because this is about the people rebuilding an altar. So the Lord began to deal with me about something concerning the women. Because the women in this hour, we honor the man and woman of God. Come on. Thank God for every man, woman, and everyone here that it came out on tonight. Thank you for coming. Hallelujah. But how many know that the Lord is doing something different in this hour? And so the Lord began to show me something, because we need to understand that it is a ripple effect that is going on right now. So it's just not about what we are seeing right now. But ripple effect means a single action. Single. See, we try to do too much. God said, I just need to do one thing. And it's going to cause a ripple effect. Look at somebody and tell them what you're doing right now. It's going to affect somebody else somewhere else. Because the Lord said that this was a divine shepherd that the people may understand and know that he is doing a complete work in this hour. He said, I set them up so that they can see unity and not adversity. anointed this assignment for. It will not just affect those that are there, but I am depositing a fresh anointing upon every vessel that has participated in this assignment. Because what he is depositing is not just for where you're at. God said that in this hour, it's about the whole totality of man. And so when he begins to set aside a time and a season for him to do a work, to birth something new, the first thing he does is call the women together. I'm about to mess up.
Teaching good.
And God began to tell me something, because you need to understand I'm going somewhere with this, because I'm about to talk about Deborah and Barak in just a minute, but we're going to talk about Deborah tonight, because some of you think you are Deborah when you are. Looking for the exit doors. I mean, some people think they are Deborah when in reality they are Jezebel mixed with Hagar. Because the Lord began to tell me, he said, in this hour we got women that are confused with what they're supposed to be doing. And so I was talking to some of the women on yesterday, last night somewhere, the woman of God, I was telling her, because I began to, somebody was talking to, and I was talking about why it is right now that the women are proposing to the men. I'm about to mess up the church money. Show me that many of the men are hypnotized and under a witchy spell, because they don't even recognize a Jezebel move. He said, when these women are proposing to a man, they are establishing the order of where they want to be. The proposals are supposed to come from the man, not the woman. Y'all don't want to hear me right now. And so I'm going to mess up. I got to get this in. Let me get it all out. Hallelujah. Because some of y'all ain't going to never come back and hear me no more after tonight. So let me just get it all out. What God showed me is happening with some of you in this house right now. Because if the scriptures in Judges, the 5th chapter, it talks about how it came a time in Israel when the men were displaced. Like they are right now. And we having a hard time trying to figure out if he's a whole man or in between sexes. And so we have a hard, y'all ain't saying nothing. So this is why I'm fighting real hard for women that are already married to real men. And no matter what's going on, you better try to stay with him if you can stay with him. Hallelujah. Because the pickings now ain't too good.
Understood that he needed her support and her help.
So I'm going to help some of you women right now. God can connect you to a man without him becoming your man. Just because he sent y'all ain't saying nothing. Just because he sent a man or sent you to work with a man don't mean that's your husband. Y'all ain't saying nothing. The first thing we as women do when we connect with men, we looking for sexual healing. When it's a spiritual awakening that God is trying to do, y'all ain't saying nothing. So the first thing he establishes, he establishes the man. Some of y'all huffing and puffing. Put your jaws in. He established that because he wants people to understand that you can be happily married. You can be happily married. And your husband don't have to be in the same dimension of authority as you. But you still got to follow orders.
You got to. You got to. You got to drop all the way down.
Look at y'all looking like you're looking. Y'all looking like you're looking. Just because you're anointed don't mean you become the head. Because the order of God does not diminish because God is raising you up. So the first thing he does is he establishes order to let them know that she's ruling with a hand. So women a lot of times forget that you need to be covered. I'm about to mess up. Those of you that are single that he's raising up, you're supposed to be covered by him. Stop looking at me crazy. You're supposed to be covered by the Lord, which means you're in submission to whatever he says and not what people are pumping up in your head. And the reason why the divorce rate is getting so heavy and the men are turning to men is because the women have castrated their manhood by making them eunuchs in their own house. Don't let me say it though. Y'all might as well go and get with it because I'm coming through like an 18-wheeler. I ain't got no brakes. I'm running over, folks. All I'm going to do is go woo. Keep on rolling, so you might as well come on, get with it.
I got a
in the fifth chapter of judgment, we begin to deal with this situation because we got to understand that without a shadow of doubt, God is getting ready to do some great things. And in the course of that, he's bringing the women to a place now where they're going to begin to really understand their identity. We're going to get in a place now where no longer will we be trained by insufficient women that don't know who they are. Why they are and whose they are. In this day and hour, God is raising up women with wisdom, of submission. Women that understand who they are and what they're called to do. The reason why we can't get the women together, because everybody is looking at everybody else's position and they're eyeing it with envy, and they don't even know what you went through to get to where you are. I can't lay hands on you and impart nothing that you ain't suffered and went through and been trained to go through. Y'all ain't saying nothing. See, we want this shortcut anointing. And so we can't get the women to stand in their position because they're too busy in competition with each other, because this one got two more followers than you. And so God is saying, in this day and hour, I'm not connecting the women with women. I'm going to connect them with a man that needs to understand who he is in the body of y'all. Ain't saying nothing. He said, because it's too much competition going on between the women for them to get together. And until we can see some examples of women and men working together in unity, we're going to continue to have competition among each other. The battle of the sexes should be going on in the body of Christ. Just because you've been hurt by one man don't mean every man is crazy.
Touching and agreeing, any two touching and agreeing, any two
touch and agree. And then Jesus established a rule that even when we go out in ministry, we are not supposed to go out by ourselves. Many times people want to be a lone ranger because they are caught up in a spotlight. In this day and hour, I'm noticing that the women in this hour are using the excuses that, no, there ain't nobody like, I got so many haters. I told somebody the other day, you ain't doing that much to have a hater. You're not doing nothing. You hating on you. You're not influencing nothing. You're not causing a change nowhere. You're not doing nothing for you to have these haters that you imagine you have. And so you need to understand that in this day and hour, people, it's not the idea that people are hating on you, but because their friends have such an influence on them. Some of you, these women, are treating you more like you their woman than they prayer partner. Y'all don't want to say nothing. Because you shouldn't have an attitude with any woman because another woman is a friend. Except you got something going on that we need to cast out. You ain't got a business getting upset because this person is connected to this person. Y'all ain't saying nothing. I got a problem with women that are trying to fight over me or something like that in that effect. Get mad because somebody else is connected to me and everything. I'm shying away. Away from all those kind of women in this hour because you got an obsession. You looking at me like I'm willing. My name is Barbara and I'm 200% woman. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Hallelujah. And so in this day and hour, God is connecting us. Come on now. And this is the reason why now you're seeing
connected to them so they can say they
Ray's entourage? What do you need 25 armor bearers for? And you ain't got but 26 people in your church. Everybody in the church is an armor bearer. Everybody in the church is ordained. And everybody got a title. God began to tell me, he said, now, I'm getting ready to put the women in a position that are able to birth this new thing that I'm getting ready to do. And so there is a changing of the guards going on right now. And this is why you see women rising up against women right now, is because they understand that this woman is getting ready to replace them. If you're not training anyone to be your successor, you out of order anyway. Now look at this line. You're supposed to be training somebody that's able to move right in when God retires you. Because there comes a time when he pulls you off the field and you just become a strict teacher. School of ministry. Y'all looking at me straight. I'm not tend to be traveling for the rest of my life. I'm going to get somewhere stationary and they're going to come to learn. That's what I'm working for. I'm working where they come find me. Looking at me screaming. Because anybody that really wants knowledge and wisdom, they will pursue it.
That's right.
Anytime you got people connected to you and you got to do all the pursuing, teaching, there's something wrong with your students. Because you're supposed to be able to give them enough to want to come. So he begins to bring it together. So now he begins to show the pattern that needs to be set now when it comes to dealing with warfare. Because we need the impartation of the man and the womb of the woman. If we don't birth anything, we can't birth it with just the women. The law of nature in the natural is the same law in the spirit. That's why when he created male and female. Because he knew that every socket needed a plug. There's nothing he made that does not have purpose. Everything has purpose because those things he made has his breath in them. His life is in all of creation. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Hallelujah. So we got to understand. He said now, it's time now for the men and women to come together and sing. Look at somebody and tell them, let's sing together. So it's time out now, women of God, for you being in a solo mode. Because God said, now I'm getting ready to connect you, because I'm getting ready to do something in the body of Christ that has become an error among my people. Because we as women, when we found out that, listen, God will use us too, because in the spirit is neither male nor female. Come on now. Hallelujah. But when we found that out, we began to allow women that were not whole to teach us. We allowed women that were going through issues, women that had been hurt by men, y'all ain't saying nothing, to begin to teach us to have contempt for men and to be offended by men. I don't He said, I gotta make him a weapon of war. I gotta make him somebody that's able to stand in the gap. Somebody that know how to intercede. Somebody that can pray. Somebody that can cover him when the enemy is trying to tempt him and pull him out the will of God. That's trying to make him forget his identity. He said, I gotta make a help me. Look at somebody and tell them, don't forget who you are. While you preaching, praying, and prophesying.
Destroying
the men. This is why I tell men, even in this hour, that you got a memory beyond a pretty face and a cute figure. Uh-oh. Some men don't miss their wives and don't merit the bride of Chucky. Because instead of him seeking God, because let me tell you something about God. God will present who he wants to the man. He presents his wife to him. He has the ability to either choose God's selection or to reject him. He speaks to the man about his wife. That's why you'll see men walk up to women sometimes they've never seen before in the natural. But their spirit is drawn to that woman. And that's why in the older generation, they married from the Spirit of God. They spoke and said, this is your husband, this is your wife. Nowadays, y'all want to court for what date for 5 and 10 years.
That's right.
Don't look at me, it's fine. Don't date, you know, 5, 10 years. Let me tell you something about a man. A man know whether he want to marry you by the 3rd month of knowing you. He already done spoke it out. And figure out whether you are the right one for him for the rest of his life. By 6 months, he's talking about marriage. I'm talking about a man. I'm talking about a playboy. I'm talking about a man, a real man. And a godly man knows who you are the minute he approaches you. Because he's walking in the spirit. And so he's looking at her in the spirit, and he knows her from the spirit realm. And this is why they married, because they heard from God. They didn't have to go on couplesmeet.com. ChristianCouples.com. Because you might have seen anything when you say Christian. Born again is different. Because everybody's saying they are Christian. You know what I'm saying. Hallelujah. And you got to go beyond, you know, tall, dark, and handsome. You understand what I'm saying? Because he's tall, dark, and handsome, but he don't want to work. He tall, you know what I'm saying? Tall, dark, and handsome, but he don't know how to govern the house. Hey, glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And so we are looking now for God to bring this thing together. And let me tell you something, for those of you that are waiting on your husbands, you can get ready, because God said in this season, as he brings the men back into their place, the husbands are getting ready to show up. Oh, I'm about to mess up. I'm about to mess up. But you can't be a wife and whore too. You gotta have been settled and wait no God. Don't look at me straight. You have to be settled and wait no God. Oh my God. Hallelujah. Some of y'all bumped your eyes when I said whore. Don't be careful. Virgin Mary since you got. He begins to sing a song. I got to drop down here. And so here it is in the seventh verse. This is what I need to get to. Because this is what the Lord said he's getting ready to do. He's about to cause the mothers to arise. Look at somebody and tell them the mothers are coming now. I'm talking about true mothers in Zion. Hallelujah. Them are the ones that watch over our soul. Come on now. They'll never get by thee. I didn't care what you was going through. They knew what you was going through. I'll never forget the mothers when I would come into the church. Hallelujah. Sometimes they would meet me at the back door. Tell them, come on, come straight to this altar. Because I saw you Saturday night. I saw you in the arms of that man. Y'all don't want to say nothing right there. Y'all listen. I'll tell you anybody, the first 2 or 3 years when I really came into the knowledge of the truth, because I was always in church.
Make it plain.
And when I came into the knowledge of the truth, for the first 2 or 3 years, I had a struggle. Because I had a good man, even in the world. That wouldn't let me struggle. That won't say nothing right there. Some of them struggling right now. I can all. That's all they heat out there. They heat out. I'm gonna see that sizzle. Electricity flying everywhere. I struggle with that. That's why I can have mercy on those that struggle. Because I understood I loved God, but I was in a struggle. Oh, we're gonna get rid of some lying spirits. And I struggled with that until I got delivered. You gotta be delivered. Yeah. You gotta come out of some things. Come on. I struggled with that until I got my last baby. And I didn't struggle with it. Because that one did it. Yeah. That was the worst pregnancy I ever had in my life. But let me struggle. Boy, it took me through. I went through with it. Sitting all the time. Everything. I went through with it. Pain all in my body. God was telling me then, do it again. Do it again if you want to. Next time, it's going to be worse. Do it again. But it taught me, and in the course of that, when I found out I was pregnant, I went to the Lord because you got to understand I was holding a position in the church.
Come on, right.
I was holding a position in the church. And was still struggling. I was praying on the prayer line and still struggling. Let me struggle. And it wasn't that the opportunity for deliverance was not made available. I didn't want to be delivered from him at that time. At the time. I don't know why I'm going here, but somebody need to know that you can come out of that struggle. I didn't want to be delivered at that time. I didn't want to be delivered. They prayed for me. I'll be on the altar crying, snotting. You know how we do.
Yeah.
Rolling all on the floor and get up and go home and tell him, meet me. Because a girl got to have it. Man, y'all look. I was a junkie. clothes, I was clothes for repair. I got clothes for repair, baby. Tell you something. Hallelujah. And then the strangest thing about it, hallelujah, he married somebody else while I was carrying his baby. I'm dipping and dabbing in sin with a man that I thought loved me, who married a simp. Could have had a wholesome girl, but I guess I wasn't too wholesome. Because I was sinning with him. Y'all ain't saying that. Don't look at me straight. And I understand now that God saw that he would be a hindrance to me really being a man. Because at that time, I probably would have did what was necessary to keep it.
That's right.
Y'all sitting in here right now, we don't have all the calling, man. And I had to get him out of me. I told God, when I got delivered, I told God, go in my bone. He in my bone now. So he in my bone now. You got to get him out of here. Narrow my bones. I said, he in there. Come on. I said, he in there. He in there. Hallelujah. He in the life substance of my body. I need you to get. Y'all looking at me strange. Hallelujah. Honey, when you want to be delivered, you'll tell God what he needs to do. I said, you got to take him out of my mind. I can't even remember who he is right now. I got to forget his name. And let me tell you something. For about 5 years, I couldn't even remember the man's name except that my song was named. Look at somebody and tell God, get ready to turn some things. And so God said, in this hour, I'm getting ready to raise up the mothers in Zion. Once again, they're coming out the corner where we don't push them, calling them old-fashioned. Oh, God. But when the mothers was in position, let me tell you something. We didn't have all this stuff we got going on in the church.
Let me explain.
Oh, let me real pray. Huh? If whatever you got on, if it can't get you down on that altar, don't wear. If you can't pray nobody through in it, don't put it on. How you gonna preach and labor with the people and you don't wanna sweat? Your makeup off, don't wear. You more concerned about whether your makeup don't run.
Outside, I got a taser and something else.
somebody and tell them we need some mamas in Zion. I'm tired of dealing with women that don't want their identity. I told God, I said, where are the women that want to make a standard in the house of God? When you begin to talk about certain things, women begin to rebel against you. They begin to oppose you and come against you. The spirit of jealousy is too heavy among the women in this hour. Competition is too strong. We're supposed to be working on the same team. All these women that run around here, they don't like me. They ain't supposed to like you. That's my assignment. It's my assignment. If they don't never like you, that's my assignment.
That's right.
My assignment is they ain't supposed to like you, but they my assignment. You can't be my friend if you're friends with them. Well, I wasn't a friend anyway. And get mad at you because God has assigned you to somebody that opposes me.
That's right.
That's not my assignment.
That's right.
That's your assignment.
That's right.
The women can ever get that in their mind.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. We're going to see a better unity among each other.
That's right.
You can't get mad because God has assigned your enemy to someone you know. Because our relationship is different.
Yes.
Let me try.
Right.
Each relationship stands on a different dimension.
Yes.
Come on. What I might be to this one, I'm not that to you.
Yes.
And so until women can understand that, and then until the mothers in Zion can get back in position where they can start teaching again, y'all want to shut us down. But I'm so glad God made room for me. He'll make room for you. He said he'll give or make room for you. So even when they don't want you, they have to call for you sometimes. Don't you ever think everybody that called for me want me. They compelled by God because somebody cried out sometime in the city. And said, we need a move of God. And he said, well, you got to go because you got the anointing for what they need. Every time you go, don't mean that, hey, my God, you're being brought by somebody that like you.
Come on.
Sometimes God will get in their spirit over in the night, give them a dream, put your name in their mind.
Yeah.
They find themselves having to call you even though they don't like you. Assignment through the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
It's not about being a friend.
No, it's not.
So look at somebody and tell them, is it your time to rise? Ask them. Look over there and ask them, is it your time to rise? Some of y'all don't want to take the position because it requires consecration.
Oh,
sanctification. Holiness and righteousness. It requires you to get rid of Mr. Mr. Make You Feel Good. It requires you getting rid of boyfriend to wait on a husband. God ain't never made provision for boyfriend. Girlfriends either. Why?
That's right.
Y'all looking at me strange. Y'all looking at me feel bad. He ain't said nothing about no girlfriend, boyfriend.
That's good teaching.
He's talking about husbands and wives.
Good teaching.
And every man have his own wife and every one of them woman have their own husband. Your 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 own husband.
Come on.
Is it?
Your own husband.
Y'all start praying, God will bring your husband out of the world where he's stuck. than you're looking over at somebody else who's trying to break up their happy home. I have zero respect for home wreckers. Look at somebody and tell them you need your own husband. Oh. Talk about the women, ain't come up to me. You need your own wife. I did not hear you talking about you need your own
husband. That's right.
So he said, she said, nothing can turn until nothing can change until I get in position. And the Lord began to show me, he said, in this region, it is so many misplaced women. He said they're connected to the wrong umbilical cord. Whoa. And what they are being nourished with is only bringing them to ruin. He said they cannot get to their destiny as long as they're connected to the wrong womb. See, you got to understand that God has positioned a mother in Zion to feed you, to nourish you, to get you to a place where you can function effectively in the body of Christ and in your home. He did not call us as women to be in opposition against the man.
That's right.
Satan came in to try to drive a wedge between man and woman. Because when the thing went down, the first thing the man said, you know what? That woman you gave me. And isn't that how they do now? When things go wrong, they say, Lord, you gave her to me. Now look what's going on. And God want to teach the women in this day and hour not to be bitter.
That's right.
Oh,
come on.
Because there's too many bitter women trying to move in the anointing.
Oh, my God.
The Spirit of the Lord said, tell the women of God, today is time to forgive everybody. Wow, my God. Listen. and go lay at his feet. Come to him humble and submissive. Let him know that you think he'll keep. Submit yourself. Because when you position at his feet, you're letting him know that you see him as the prince and the king. And you'll protect. She knew how to, pimp him out. Y'all didn't read the story? The Lord began to tell me something. He said, y'all didn't even run around talking about they want to go away. Boaz didn't live that long. He didn't live that long. So you want a man gonna die when you quit? Lift your hands and say, God, help me.
God, help me.
To stay in my position.
To stay in my position.
The Bible said that nothing changed until Deborah got up and came through as a mother in Israel. Then the 12th verse begins to say, awake, awake, Deborah.
Yes.
Awake, awake. Arise, Barak, and lead the captivity captive. Then he made him that remained have dominion over the nobles among the people. The Lord made me have dominion over the mighty. Do you understand what he's saying? Barak, I'm going to put you in a leadership position. Deborah, you in a warfare position.
Oh God, I got my God.
Because you won't be over the mighty. The ones that are skilled and know how to fight. Barak, you won't have to stand here with those that took no strategy.
Oh God.
They should know strategy. They should know how to protect the people. The ones of influence. But women of God, I come to let you know that in this hour God said tonight, I'm proclaiming you as the defenders of the warriors. He said, I'm placing you over the warriors. This is why we got to teach our young women what's right.
Yes. Yes.
Because these are the warriors that are being released in this
house.
Hey, Lord. Spirit of the Lord began to tell me, he said, every woman from the age of 59 is getting ready to shift into a double portion of warfare anointing.
Hallelujah.
He said, they're getting ready to go to battle now. Because we got to time this thing. Oh, God. Look at somebody and tell them the warriors are getting ready to come now. This is what he said. This is why the mothers in Zion got a long time so that they can put the warriors in position now. Open your mouth and thank him for the warriors coming on. Get the warriors in position now. Where are the weapons of war at? That's what he's saying. Where are the weapons of war at? Where are my weapons at in the kingdom? Where are my weapons at? Am I leading them to come on now? We gotta take the region. We gotta take the nation. We gotta go global. We ain't got time to be quiet about this. Come on. journeys of life and have been through terrible things, even through life. He said all those things were to teach them warfare. That's why you couldn't die. When they wanted you dead, you couldn't die. Because God was waiting on this time. There is a release that is taking place now. And God is releasing women from the bondages of the past. This is why you see deliverance is taking place. And many of them are being delivered privately. In the privacy of their home. There's been a lot of purging that's been taking place.
Just finished listening to the media ministry of Apostle Barbara R. Thomas. You may write her at Apostle Barbara R. Thomas, P.O. Box 13291, Durham, North Carolina 27709. Thank you for supporting the ministry.